All right, what is going on, guys? Today we're going to be changing it up a little. We're going to be learning about recurrence relations. Now we're going to be solving this solution here with the help of the theorem one. So if you guys know, so we're trying to find the solution of the recurrence relation, and you're given the essentially, you're given the recurrence relation right here, and you're given the A1 value, the A0 value, and the A1 value right here. So what you do is first you have to remember the basics. By the basics, I mean you have to know that. Let me go ahead and let me just go ahead and use blue right here. So you have to know that A of n is the same thing as r to the n, right? It's pretty much the same formula here, same thing here. So we can translate that to theorem one. So let me use this. So theorem one basically gives you the formula right here. It's gonna be a of n is equal to c1 times r1 squared plus c2 to the r of n to r2 to the n, right? So that is the formula we're gonna be essentially ending up with at the very end. But to start off, let's go ahead and work on this using the theorem one. First thing we want to do is essentially get the r values there. Now, how do you get the r values? Well, you have to realize, you have to know the formula right here, that r squared plus sorry, r squared minus, and then you take the coefficient right here, which is 1 right here. So you just take just r, and then minus the coefficient here, just 2, and you set that equal to 0. So you're essentially just getting the coefficients from here, and this is your r value right here. This is your r. And then you get the last coefficient right here. And so once we have this formula right here, what you would need to do is just solve for r. So to solve for r, the easiest way is the little diamond method. Not sure if you guys have ever heard of this, but what you do is you basically take the a times the c, which in this case is negative 2, and then you put the b value right here, the negative 1 at the bottom. So you have to find something that multiplies to get negative 2 but adds to get negative 1. So in this case, it would be negative 2 and 1, because if you multiply negative 2 and 1, you get negative 2. If you add negative 2 and 1, you get negative 1. So that's how you get that. So you come up with the r minus 2, and then the r plus 1, set that equal to 0. Then once you have that, you're gonna go ahead and essentially go through this and you solve for the r. So the r1 is equal to 2, and then the r2 is equal to negative 1. So we just literally just sidestep that problem, or we did it like r minus 2 equals 0, and you get r equals 2. It's basically like that. So we just did it in our head. I mean, if you're doing this anyways, simple math. So, but I would recommend, if you're doing it in an exam or something, then definitely take the time to do it out. All right, and then once we have that, now we know our r values right here. So We want to box out the R values because these are very important right here. I suck at boxing things in. All right, there you go. And then what you basically do is you basically take this one and this one, and you basically push it to that one. So how we can do that is very, very simple. We just simply plug it in. So we have the R1 and the R2, and you see how right here, this is the R1 and this R2. So you just literally just plug it in to the formula there. So I'm gonna literally just plug it in here. So we're gonna do A of M is equal to, again, we don't know the C. We know what R1 is, which is 2 to the N, and we know what R2 is, so it's gonna be C2. We don't know C2 yet. And then R1 is just negative 1 to the N, like that. So we basically just took our R values, 1 and 2, and just plugged it in right here. And that's how we get this. So this is coming from this right here. All right, now, once we have that, the fun part begins. Now, the fun part is you have to solve for the C1 and the C2. Now, how in the world are you gonna get this? Well, that's where our friends, the initial values come in with the A0 is equal to 2, the A1 is equal to 7. So now what we can do is a little trick that I like to call plug and chug. So you basically have N is equal to 0, and you basically plug in the A0. So you just literally plug in 0 to this, and we have A of 0 is equal to C of 1 to the 2 of 0 plus C to the 2, get negative 1 to the 0. All right, now some of you guys already know where I'm going, but if you don't, no worries. So we have A to the 0 equals, no, this is equal to 1, so we just have C1. And then this is equal to 1 as well, so we just have plus C2. And remember how we have A of 0 is equal to 2? Well, we have A of 0 right here as well, and you see the N came from right here. The N came from right here, and we basically plugged in the N into here, into the formula right here. And we get this. Once we get this, you solve for it, and you know this becomes 1, this becomes 1. So it's a C1 times 1, C2 plus C2 times 1. So you have C1 plus C2. Then once you have that, you remember, hey, A of 0 is equal to 2. Therefore, this is equal to 2. Now we're getting somewhere, right? Now we're getting somewhere. And then you do the same exact thing right here. You essentially plug in the N of 1 because you're given the 1 right here. There you go. The 1 right here, which is equal to 7. So you just literally just plug that in. And you get, let's see, A of N. Or A of 1, sorry, A of 1, yeah, we'll just plug it in, is equal to 2 of 1, or sorry, I forgot the C, should I forget the C, so you get C of 1 to the 2 of 1 plus C to the 2 times negative 1 to the 1, and when you do the calculating here, you get A of 1 is equal to C or 2C1 plus, not plus, but negative, because this is equal to just negative 1 right here. This is negative 1. So we just get negative C2. There you go. All right. Because anything to the 1, is going to be that number. So if you have, let's say, we'll just use greener here. Well, if you have like 5 to the 1, that equals 5. If you have 6 to the 1, you have 6. But if you have, let's say, 5 to the 0, that equals 1. 6 to the 0 is going to be 1. It's just a rule you should just memorize, because I just like to keep these memorized there. All right, now next what we're gonna get into is we're gonna solve for this. And well, you remember here we have a of 1, and we know from here that a of 1 is equal to 7, therefore this number is equal to 7. Now, do you guys see what I have here? This is one chunk of it, and this is the other. We have two formulas, and we can now use a system of equations to essentially solve that. So we can just have both of them here. So the first one is going to be c of 1 plus c of 2 is equal to 2. Second one is 2c of 1 minus c of 2 is equal to 7. And then we have these two will cancel. We have 3 to the c1 equals 9. And if you divide that by 3, that by 3, you have c1 equals to 3. And then we can just plug it in. We can plug in the c1 to the original formula, or well, one of the original equations. So we'll just pick this one right here. We'll literally just pick that one right there. So we have the, yeah, so we have, yeah, we'll just choose that one. So we have the c1, which is 3. So we'll just do 3. Plus c2 equals to 2 minus 3 minus 3, and we get c2 is equal to negative 1. There you go. Now we have the c1 value and the c2 value. Now what we do is we have all of the chunks in place, and now we can finally plug and chug into this. So we have. So the final thing, okay, I'm gonna draw it right here at the bottom. So we have a to the n is equal to c1, which is 3, times the r1, which is 2 to the n, and then you have the minus, and then you have minus, and then you have the negative 1 to the n. Yep, there you go. So that will be your final answer there. That's how you get that as the solution to this. So that is the solution. Now I'm gonna briefly go over this again in case you missed a part of it or something, and we'll just take it slowly here. So we have, what is the solution of the recurrence relation? Well, first you have to see, okay, you're given this. Okay, and we know that a0 is equal to 2, a1 is equal to 7. Now we have to remember this. A of n is equal to the r of n. That's already given, right? And theorem 1 is simply this. A of n equals c1 times r1 to the n plus c2 times r2 to the n. Now, this part is a little confusing. It was confusing to me as well, but what you do is you just essentially just remember it. If you're given a recurrence relation like this, like if it's n minus 1 and n minus 2, this would be the formula you use to get the r values essentially. So to get the r values, you have the r squared right here, and then you have the r. Now this r can change based on the coefficient of this first number here. The coefficient changes it, and then this number is the coefficient of whatever number you have right here. So that's how we get this, and then we just simply solve for the r values, and we get r1 equals 2, r2 equals negative 1. And then once we have that, we can simply just go on through, and we see here that you have this formula from when we plugged in the R1 and the R2 into this formula right here. Into the theorem, sorry, into the theorem. And then we just take n of 0, which comes from this right here, and we plug in chug. We get that C1 plus C2 equals 2, because again, A of 0 is equal to 2, therefore this equation is equal to 2. And then we do the same thing for for n equals 1. You just plug in 1 and you get this formula right here. And then you take both of these formulas and you do a system of equations. You solve C1 equals 3 and then C2 equals negative 1. And you just simply just plug into this formula right here. Sorry, this formula right here. And that's where we get this once we plug in everything. And that's your final answer. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments. But yeah, that's gonna end it right here. I hope you enjoyed this. I know it's definitely a tougher subject, but once you understand the flow of it, it's pretty straightforward. And yeah, if you need any more practice, let me know. That's gonna end it right here. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.